In today's video, we will provision an EKS cluster and Fargate, and then deploy an Nginx Docker image on the cluster. Also, I'll show how to fix Coredns addon deployment issue. All steps are using the AWS Management console without installing AWS and kubectl commands on your local box. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lian Duan, and I have developed for over 20 years, specializing in DevOps and cloud security. All video-related content and code are in my GitLab repo. The links are below. Today, topics are: what is Fargate in EKS? What are the benefits of using Fargate with EKS? And hands-on demos: create an EKS cluster and Fargate profile via AWS console. Let's start. Fargate on EKS concept. Amazon EKS, or Elliptical Kubernetes Service, provides a managed Kubernetes service that simplifies to deployment, management, and scaling of container-like applications using Kubernetes. It's called a control plane in AWS EKS architecture. EKS has two data planes, an EC2-based data plane and a Fargate data plane. EKS can use one of them or use two types of data plan together. Check out my video, Create EKS and EC2 with AWS console. It has step-by-step guidelines for building an EC2 data plan. Today, we are focused on the Fargate data plan. What is Fargate? Fargate is a serverless computing engine for containers. If you're interested in the Fargate, check out my Fargate video playlist. Fargate profile lies a bridge for EKS and Fargate. The Fargate profile tells EKS which containers should run on the Fargate. EKS manages the Fargate by itself. We only has read-only permission for the EKS managed Fargate on the Fargate console. Are there benefits of using Fargate with EKS? Easy management. Fargate eliminates the need of provision and managed service for Kubernetes cluster, allowing developers to focus on application development rather than the infrastructure management. No need for servers. Fargate provides a serverless experience for running containers and enabling great agility in deploying and scaling applications. Handle traffic automatically. Fargate offers automatic scaling and high availability, ensure that applications can handle varying levels of traffic without manual action, so it improves reliability and efficiency. After we know the Fargate concept and benefits, move to hands-on demos. We will create an EKS cluster and then attach a Fargate profile to the cluster. After they're running, an Nginx will deploy it. Before diving into the hands-on demos, ensure you have two IAM roles, EKS admin and EKS Fargate. EKS admin has Amazon EKS cluster policy and it used by EKS. Fargate has Amazon EKS Fargate pod execution role policy. The role needs by Fargate profile. Also, you need a VPC for EKS and Fargate profile. This is my demo virtual private cloud on AWS with multiple subnets in different availability zones. The demo VPC with a specific IP addresses range is 10.0.0.0/16. The VPC has two public subnets, public 01 and public 02. The EKS uses public subnets and Fargate deploys to the private subnets. Based on the AWS document, Fargate cannot be on public subnets with EKS. The public subnets using an internet gateway to go to internet, and the private subnets, NAT gateway for outbound internet traffic. If you do not have it yet, you can create the VPC from console or clone my GitLab repository, and then go to code folder, run two commands, terraform init and terraform apply to create the VPC. To create in progress, we move to hands-on demo detail. We'll do below hands-on demos together. Create an EKS cluster. Create a Fargate profile with two namespaces. Deploy Nginx pod and fix EKS Coredns pod deployment issue. Open the AWS console. Log into the AWS with my root user. If you use another AWS account, make sure your account has all the needed permissions. Sign in as root user. Sign in. In the services area, search EKS. Select Electrical Kubernetes Service. Select Create Cluster. The cluster name is EKS Demo. Select a previous version 1.28 because in the future video, I'll demo how to upgrade Kubernetes version. Use EKS admin role. The role only has one policy, Amazon EKS cluster policy. Cluster access uses default selections. Add one tag, demo EKS. Go to next page. VPC select EKS demo VPC 01. Subnets selection only keep the public subnets in there. Remove private subnets. Ignore security groups as now. Class endpoint access use public and private. Go next. Ignore login configure as now. Click next. Only select three default addons. Go to next page. The addon version use default value. Go to next page. Click create button. Back to cluster's list UI. Refresh. You see the EKS demo cluster is creating now. It will take from 10 minutes to 20 minutes. You see the support notification. Do not worry about it right now. I'll show you how to upgrade to the latest version. After the cluster is active, the next part is create a Fargate profile. Click a cluster name. Go to the computer type. Move a little bit down. Add a Fargate profile. Name is EKS Fargate Demo. Execution role select EKS Fargate. Subnet use two private subnets. Add one tag. Demo. Value is EKS. Go to next page. We will create two namespaces. First namespace is demo namespace. We'll use to deploy our Nginx pod. Second namespace name is kube-system. The namespace we'll use to deploy the Coredns addon. Add a match label for Coredns selection. The key is kubectl. Value is kube-dns. Go to next page. Review all the information. Create. The profile creating take around 10 minutes. Fargate is active right now. Let me clarification. EKS use Fargate profile to create a Fargate cluster and manage the Fargate cluster itself. We are able to see the Fargate in the Fargate console. Let me switch the type. But you cannot do any management on the cluster. For example, deploy the new pod from here. It just like view permission for us. Back to the EKS console. The Fargate is available now. While using the AWS Cloud Shell to deploy an Nginx Docker image on the cluster, click Cloud Shell. Make the shell screen bigger. First command, run AWS STS get seller identity command to check AWS identity. We are in the root user right now. STS means Security Token Service. This command provides information about AWS identity to ensure your current account has the right permissions. Next, check the kubectl version. Command is kubectl space version space -- client. If you do not install the kubectl yet, follow the document to install in your cloud shell. Back to the console. Next step, use AWS EKS update-kubeconfig command to update the kubectl file for our demo EKS cluster. Clean up the screen. The following step, create a namespace and deploy Nginx Docker image. The command is kubectl apply space -f plus the deploy YAML file location. Let me copy the file, open the new tab to quick go through the deployment file together. There are two parts on the file. First part, create a demo namespace on the EKS, and then deploy a Nginx Docker image on the namespace. Replica size is 3. We should see the 3 pods running for the Nginx. Back to the cloud shell. Enter. Namespace created successfully. Deploy Nginx Docker image in progress. Deploy completed. Back to the UI. Go to EKS demo and then go to computer type. Under the resources, we should see the 3 Nginx deployments. Check the status. It's running. Back to the list page. How about the Coredns? The Coredns running the scheduling issue. The message is no nodes available to the scheduled pods. We already created the kubectl namespace. Why we still face the issue? When you go to internet, search the message, you will see we have to run some Coredns patch or remove the annotation on the deployment file. Actually, this is not true for the current 1.28 version. To fix it, very simple. Open the cloud shell again. Do the cleanup. Use kube rollout restart command to redeploy the Coredns. Use kubectl git pod command to check the status. No resource found in the default namespace. Let me add the namespace parameter. Move the space and run again. You see the Coredns pods are running. Close the cloud shell. Back to the UI. Go to resources. You will see the old file pods are running. Go to the computer type. Refresh. You will see 5 nodes are running. 2 for Coredns. 3 for my Nginx deployment. The, based on the EKS document, each Fargate node only running 1 pod. You may have a question. How to access my Nginx pod? There's only one way we can do it. Use ingress. Please subscribe to my channel. I'll show you how to do it in the future. That's all for today's video. We use the AWS EKS console, create an EKS cluster, and attach Fargate profile on the cluster, and then create 2 namespaces. Use the demo namespace, deploy the Nginx pod. Use the kubectl namespace, deploy the Coredns addons, and fix the Coredns deployment issue. By the way, do not forget to delete all the resources after your exercise completed to save your money. Delete the Fargate profile first. When deleted, delete the EKS cluster. Finally, delete the demo VPC. Thank you and see you the next time.